There is a clock which moves faster than a normal clock and continuously gains time. At Sunday 8 a.m., the clock lags behind the actual time by 5 minutes, 5 seconds, while the next Sunday 8 p.m., the clock leads the actual time by 11 minutes, 35 seconds. Find the day and the time in that week at which the clock would have told the correct time. You are watching Brain Exploders, the world where brain starts working. Suppose there are two clocks, one of which shows actual time and other one is that clock which is given in our question. This clock covers more time in comparison to the normal clock. On the screen, this extra time is shown much greater than actual just for explanation. On Sunday at 8 a.m., clock B is 5 minutes 5 seconds behind the normal clock, so time on it is 7:54:55 a.m. On next Sunday at 8 p.m., clock B is 11 minutes 35 seconds ahead. We have to find that moment at which the time of clock B crossed the time of clock A. Let us take a problem analogous to this problem, which can be worked out by speed distance time formula. Suppose there is a car B behind car A which travel with a greater velocity than that of car A. So it overtakes car A after some time. We will try to find this time. Let the distances traveled by car A and B are x and y respectively. Both the cars travel these distances in the same time delta t. Extra distance traveled by car B over here is y minus x. It means speed of car B relative to car A is y minus x over delta t. Because with respect to car A, this is the only distance traveled by car B. To calculate the time taken by B to overtake A, we also need initial distance between them. So let the initial distance between them is delta x. Now, time taken to overtake is equal to initial distance over relative speed. Let's come to our question. Here, time difference between Sunday 8 a.m. and next Sunday 8 p.m. is 12 hours more than a week. It is equal to 180 hours. Time gained by clock B in this derivation is equal to 5 minutes 5 seconds plus 11 minutes 35 seconds. It is equal to 16 times 60 plus 40 seconds or 1000 seconds. Thus, the rate of time gain by clock B is 1000 seconds per 180 hours. You can convert hours in seconds, but there is no need to do this. Here, rate of time gain by clock B is analogous to relative speed and initial time difference is analogous to initial distance. Therefore, time taken by B to overtake A is initial time difference over rate of time gain. It comes out to be 54.9 hours. 0.9 hours is equivalent to 54 minutes. On adding 54 hours 54 minutes in Sunday 8 a.m., we get Tuesday 2:54 p.m. Let's move to our another question. A semicircular disc of radius 1 meter is hung from ceiling with a string of length 1 meter tied to one of its corners as shown below. Find the distance of the lowermost point on disc from ceiling. Try this question and send us your solution, and if you have any question like this, then please share with us. Don't forget to like and share our video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel Brain Exploders. Thanks for watching.